right, great, let's get it going. If you're new to this channel and these videos, what we do here is we look, we inquire, and we inquire and we do so focusing our attention on what we may not have focused on before. So what you get here is going to be challenging to your belief systems, for sure. That's the whole point of it. Inquiry is to challenge your belief system, your beliefs, to challenge them, to look at them and challenge them. So it should be like, oh, wow, this is very challenging. That's the whole point of it. So we have some incredibly challenging look-sees here in this video. These have been developing over the last several days. A couple of things, the main topics. Comet ISON is actually a main topic, all right? It's not just some little sideshow. It is a big, big, big deal, as a matter of fact. The other is how to sidestep the coming troubles in the world, okay? That is even bigger issue, all right? And I tell you this, there is a way to do it. There is a way to do it. It keeps being pointed out to me, wow. Just like, it's very close to, for myself, to do it, actually. The subtlety is, we're not used to seeing it. And it's so simple, it may just slip right through our fingers. And we say, oh my gosh, I had it, now it's gone. What happened? To put it in a nutshell, let us say that somehow you were enlightened, quote unquote. And of course the ego is going to ask you, well, how did you do it? And the answer is really that you realize that how you did it doesn't matter. That's how you did it. And when you can get to that point and see that how you do it doesn't matter at all. In fact, how anybody does it doesn't matter in the slightest bit. Because we won't be comparing notes. It doesn't matter. It's like waking up from a dream. Everybody wakes up from a dream. They're all awake from the dream. Equally awake. So at that point, how does it matter? Well, how did we wake up? How did you wake up in the dream? Everyone's going to be different. Well, I woke up this way, that way. We're not going to be comparing notes. No. So how we get to salvation, the how of it, it doesn't matter. And since it doesn't matter, since the end is certain, as a matter of fact, we will awaken. We will set this dream, this training program down. Is it really a training program trying to teach ourselves how to die, which is futile? We cannot die. Spirit cannot die. We will all set it down. So the how doesn't matter at all. It doesn't matter. If you can see that, the subtlety of it, then boom, you know that you've got it. And the subtlety may slip away from you, as it did for me today. I saw it today very clearly, and now it's less clear, okay? But I'm just giving you a sense of it. It doesn't matter how. It doesn't make any difference. All that matters is that we accept the perfect know of the Holy Spirit, which solves the continuity issue for us, really. So how we do it by realizing the how doesn't matter. That's how we do it. And our future perfect self is actually here right now with us, because it doesn't matter to how we get there. If it doesn't matter how we get there, then why not get there right now? So you can go any which way you want to in awakening. It doesn't matter which way you go. You can, whatever you want to do, however you do it, that's fine. So if it doesn't really matter how anyone does it, and it doesn't matter, then why don't we just do it right now? What are we waiting for? We're waiting to find out the how of it. Well, how do we do it? It doesn't matter. The goal is certain. Our future perfect self is already there waiting for us. It's already right here, because it knows how we do it doesn't matter. It's not waiting for a how. Nobody's waiting. Our future perfect self is not waiting for a how at all. It's already perfect. So it doesn't need a how. And all we need to do is accept that this is the solution of the continuity problem. So the clarity of this was crystal clear for me today. And I know that in seeing that, that is very close to actually, you know, being safe from the continuity issue and safe from this crazy death-based training program, which is going to get very severe quite soon, very soon. Now, here is an amazing, amazing scenario I'm going to paint for you, which just came to light today. It's a hypothesis at this point. It hasn't quite gelled into a theory yet, but I'm going to share it with you here first. I may make a separate video on this, but let me just go over the gist of this because it fits everything together that was before not quite fit together. I couldn't figure out. I was thinking today, how can a comet really cause that much trouble? We're talking about the tribulation period and all the troubles, etc. And I started thinking, you know what? In my mind, I started thinking, well, the comet does this and this and this. And I said, how can it really wreak complete havoc on the planet to the extent that many have seen? And honestly, I concluded, I don't think it can. I don't think it can. And then the question came, well, then how can the tribulation period really happen? I said, that's a very good question. Then I started connecting various facets that I understand. What I believe is likely to happen, this is a scenario, a possible scenario, is that, let's put it this way, there's all these things, situations that have been set up ahead of time, okay? For instance, the collapse of the economy, the nano flu, all these various horrible tribulations and trials that have been designed to decimate the population of the planet, which is really the goal of the New World Order, the elites. They want to cull the population, eugenics, and bring the population planet way, way, way down. Okay. All this nasty stuff has been set up. We know that. We're all aware, kind of like, you know, there's all these terrible things, and yet, how are they going to happen, really? Can it really happen? Now, what I did was I put the Comet ISON and all this blueprint for decimating the population of the planet together. I put them together. I said, oh, wait a minute. Now, what if Comet ISON, for example, is simply being used as a cover, as a camouflage, as an excuse, a cover for all these terrible programs that have been set up? For instance, let's say ISON comes in and we go through its debris field and there's all this dust and there's, you know, stones coming in, hitting the earth and stuff. And okay, that's problematic, right? Now, what if at the same time there was a nano flu particle in people, a lot of people in the world, that the frequency, radio frequency, activated that and people started getting sick all over the world? Well, the experts would say, wow, this is like a MERS, M-E-R-S, MERS-like syndrome here. This is like a bird flu-like syndrome, and it must have been caused by the comet. All the dust and stuff that's going on must have caused it. So they would say this is a pandemic and blame it on the comet. The same thing going through the debris field of the comet, etc. They have a program designed to crash the world financial system because it's all based on computers. I know they have this setup. They could crash it, okay? Crash the whole financial system of the planet and say that the comet knocked out all the satellites, knocked the satellites out and fried their electronics and therefore caused the computers to malfunction, when in fact, the comet didn't do that. So again, blame it on the comet. So they have all these black ops ready to go. And what they're going to do is they're going to blame it all on the comet. So people will just accept it and say, oh my gosh, the comet is wreaking havoc on the planet. So the financial system collapses, and with this, everybody having this terrible flu-like symptoms and dying, all travel will be shut down, martial law will be imposed throughout the whole world. All of this blamed on the comet. We say, oh, the comet is destroying the planet. We must control everybody, you know. Where in fact, the comet is doing some trouble, but it's being used as an excuse. This is what I see now it answers so many questions, actually. It's now, those who have designed the blueprint to basically wipe out the population of this planet, They're very sneaky, they're very tricky, this has been done before, and they actually, if you're going to do something so diabolical, what are you going to do? You're going to look for something to blame it on, so the blame doesn't fall on you. And so they know about this comet, They know about the situations of using comets to blame what they do, man-made catastrophe. They blame it on the comet and say, well, it's a God, judgment of God. God is wreaking judgment upon the planet, raining judgment upon the planet. Now, they may have done this back in Noah's Ark time. As a matter of fact, the Great Flood, I think, from what I understand, it was intentionally triggered by the Anunnaki, by extraterrestrials, actually, because the people on the planet weren't doing what they wanted to do, so they basically killed them all. And they, you know, blamed it on God. So God always gets the blame for man-made, sinister, black op type of operations designed to wipe large, you know, humanity out. So blame it on the comet is what is coming up, in my opinion. It could very well be this. And people will not realize that they're, you know, everyone's dying from a technological implant in them that's been activated, causing their immune system to overreact and flooding their lungs. They think that this is bird flu. They're all being conditioned to think, oh yeah, this is MERS, this is bird flu, and it's been, the dust is aggravating it, and the comet is aggravated, and it's all because of the comet. So in history, it'll go down, the survivors will say, my gosh, the terrible comet of, you know, 2013 wreaked havoc upon the planet and brought all these terrible tribulations and trumpets, you know, poured out upon the planet. You hear in Revelation all these vials being poured out upon the planet, you know, and one by one decimating the planet. But I tell you this, it's very likely that what is being poured out upon the planet is man-made, human-made, or ET-made. Biological agents, various implants, things that we've taken into our body, nanotechnology is being used, a lot of different things, the camps that people will be brought into, frequency attacks on the planet. Those things those vials are not natural catastrophe. Tribulation is not a natural catastrophe. It is something that is being done and using the comet as a cover. It's using the comet as a cover story, a facade, a cover story for what they're actually doing. Okay? And people will buy this hook, line, and sinker. They'll think, oh my God, look what the comet is doing. We're being chastised by God. We're being judged by God. All this nonsense. God doesn't chastise or judge anything in our dream at all. God knows this is all simply a virtual reality, a plausible hypothetical scenario of training program, trying to teach ourselves how to die. We can't die. God knows we can't die. God doesn't judge any of this at all. God's judgment is a perfect non-judgment, a perfect no, that no, you can't die. And his answer was to give the Holy Spirit to us, and that is no, you can't die. Here is a vision of your perfect future self, as it were. At the end of this dream, you can see yourself as perfect and flawless, and that reminds you of reality. God has an answer to this crazy dream that we have. But certainly it's not one of judgment at all. This is a ruse. It's a ruse. It is a ruse carried out by those who want to decimate civilizations and planets, etc. Blame it on the comet. Blame it on the comet. Okay? And we know that there's weather modification, for instance, taking place on this planet. There's a matter of fact, there's all sorts of high technologies that we haven't not even aware of, or if they are, they're black ops, that can cause incredible problems, like in Atlantis time, with the use of crystals and resonant frequencies, etc., all this stuff, causing massive, massive destruction on the planet. But what they want to do is they want to say it's the comet, it's God, you know, blame it on God, basically, to distract away from what they're doing. Now, we don't have to actually call the population of this planet. If we change our lifestyles to a lifestyle of inquiry, which is what we're supposed to do, you will find the carbon footprint of the humanity dropping incredibly, but probably by like 90% would drop. The planet would regenerate, it would heal, etc., if we live a proper lifestyle, which is to focus on the Holy Spirit and the Holy Spirit's solution to the continuity problem. And this is what I have done. And I know that the answer is there, very simple. That would change everything in the world. The fact is that we're pursuing this secular, humanist, materialistic, avenue, which is decimating the planet. There's no question that we're using up the resources and decimating the planet. But we don't have to live that way. We don't have to get rid of humanity. It's not necessary. We can change our focus. But it doesn't look like the planet is doing that. But I would certainly welcome everybody to do that and make your focus. For instance, whatever is made should be made to last generations, okay? This nonsense of a disposable, everything is disposable. You know, get a new smartphone every year or something like that. Those are a bunch of precious metals in there, and rare metals, or rather. And all this stuff is consuming the planet. Why not make something that lasts for generations? You know, we used to have the world was that way. That what, you know, like for instance, our flatware, the silverware, most of the pans, you know, I have been in the family for 50, 60 years, you know, and passed down from my grandmother stuff, still fine, still using it. Stuff used to get passed down from generation to generation to generation. We can build homes in ways that are very renewable. A lot of things we can do. It's like used to be built homes of stone. The stone would last, you know, 1,000, 2,000 years or something like that. we are just, our whole lifestyle is madness, actually. It really is madness. And it is because we're not listening to the Holy Spirit. And so to fill the void, we think something's wrong with us, and the ego manipulates us, and we think we gotta have more of everything. New stuff, better stuff, come on, you know. I mean, people used to have just several garments. They wear the garments their whole lifetime. They have a nice thick linen, or wool, or linen, or something that can last, you know, most of your lifetime. A pair of sandals might last you 10, 15 years. A really good pair of sandals, or, you know, a couple pair of sandals. Nowadays, people, you know, go through everything so fast. So you got all 7 billion people just like grasshoppers or locusts, you know, just eating up the planet. It doesn't have to be that way. If you turn to a life of contemplation, which we should do, because the answer is right there. I was staring it right in the face today. And I said, that's it, I see it. There's no reason to wait at all, since the how doesn't matter at all. Why even wait? Why try to develop a how? How did I get to enlightenment? Doesn't matter. What I did in the past, what I do in the future, it doesn't matter at all, because the end result is all going to be the same no matter how you do it. No matter how you get there, no matter how you climb the mountain, the end result is going to be the same. So why wait? Why wait and even have a how at all? Don't need a how. For what? What is the how for? For somebody who can't do it? We're all in the same boat. None of us needs a how. None of us needs a how did we do it, so to speak. That is getting you right to the root of actually accepting the resolution, the continuity issue, which I've gone over in many videos and will in the future for sure again. But what I'm pointing out here is that there could very well be a very severe tribulation and troubles on this planet, human-made. And the comet is just going to provide the distraction, like a magician. You know, a magician has a distraction, right? So they don't see what they're doing, with quickly sleight of hand. The comet is just the distraction device, and they knew that this comet is coming. And they planned everything ahead of time, so they had it ready to go. So when this comet came in and started doing its thing and scaring everybody, they'd be able to trigger all their, you know, little magic tricks and blame it on the comet. So this is a very interesting theory, because it acknowledges the catastrophes and problems to come, but it also acknowledges humanity's role in doing this, and acknowledges that the comet can cause some troubles. Yes, absolutely. But that again is used as an excuse. Martial law, you know, just all laws. Habeas corpus, everything suspended, all laws suspended, police state, and then people are just taken and relocated into these camps, etc., and nobody will do anything about it. They say, hey, it's necessary, the comet has caused massive famine. There's another thing. The whole economic system can be crashed and shut down, and no food available for anybody, etc., and it can be all blamed on the comet. Oh, the comet has caused crop failure here, all this stuff, you know, trouble here. The whole thing can be staged that way. Blame it all on the comet. So this is a good reason to leave ahead of time. Now, I was just out in my garden today and I sighted, you know, flowers and stuff. It's too late. They're not going to mature well at this time. So I said, let's just pull them. I'm going to plant a winter garden tomorrow. I got some help on that, fortunately. So I decided, let's not wait. Let's do it now. If we know what is likely to happen and that there's going to be this excuse of the comet to do all sorts of very vile things to cull the population of the planet, there's no reason to hang around here. Why? What are we? We're seeing some sort of natural thing? It's not natural what's happening. It's not natural at all. So that excuse of, I want to see what happens in nature, let nature take its course, that's not what's happening. It's not what's happening. You know, they can manufacture earthquakes too, okay? They can do all sorts of stuff now. And the comet will be used to an excuse. I mean, some people thought that the Japanese earthquake was somehow triggered, humanity, man-made triggering it. So various technologies that they have now, which are very black op and we're not aware of them, can be used to trigger all sorts of natural catastrophes, volcanoes, earthquakes, etc., stuff like that. Blame it on the comet, blame it on the comet, blame it on the comet. Perfect alibi, you see? It's an alibi. It's an alibi for this stuff. And they know it. They're waiting for this alibi. So this is a new theory that needs to be looked at. And if it is true, why wait around for this stuff? Why wait around for it? If we can relocate, if we can sidestep it, why not do it now? Why wait? Why wait? I found that I'm doing stuff now, right now, instead of waiting. I said, you know what? Those tomatoes can go through December if it's warm, but why fool around? They're not going to be that good anyway. You know, what kind of victory is that? I grew my tomatoes toward December. They're not going to be good. So take them out and put some broccoli in or something. You know, don't wait around. So if it is true that this comet is just an alibi for all this skullduggery, then why should we wait around for this? Stupid. Get out ahead of time, as it were. Get out ahead of time. So there you have it. This is amazing, amazing breakthrough to see this and say, oh my gosh, this is a real possibility, actually. Real possibility. You know, the computer glitches all over the place. Oh my, you know, just, whoa. You know, our computers aren't working anymore. The comet has really messed everything up. So, it's a game changer. This theory, hypothesis, and working towards theory is really a game changer because it changes our attitude to the whole situation. At least it does mine. I say, I'm not going to sit around here and wait till they, you know, for the triggering some nano flu. I'm not going to hang around. That's stupid. For what purpose? You know, they're just blaming this stuff on the comet. The comet's not causing it. The idea is scientists are supposed to be studying natural phenomena, and I'm kind of a scientist in some ways. I think we all have some sort of scientific feeling in us. Like, I like to study natural process and history and all this stuff, empirical, what is actually happening, what's causing stuff. But if it's actually being faked, you know, blamed on the comet, but actually the comet is not causing it. You got, you know, HARP or something causing this stuff, and various all sorts of stuff causing it. Where's the opportunity to be a scientist? That is not here. It's not here. The comet is not causing all this trouble. And so we're getting false evidence. Really bad conclusions from false evidence. So it's just like, wow, forget it. You know, forget it. We've been duped. Well, that's my attitude. I was warned about a severe pandemic back in about 2002, I think it was, 2003. I was told that there's going to be an incredible worldwide pandemic killing maybe a quarter of the population of the planet. And so I became an expert in the bird flu. I spent 2 years just intense study about all this stuff. And then I said, you know what, it's something is not quite right about this, and what's going on? And now we Now we have some information that makes sense about a man-made, man-engineered, small nano flu particle that people can get through their water and their food, which can be activated, remotely activated to cause the immune system to overreact, which is what bird flu essentially does. It kills people through filling their lungs with fluid, which comes about from the immune system over-responding and not shutting down. It produces so much activity that this actually causes the lungs to shut down. And this can be provoked from within. It's certainly possible. I mean, if you look at what they did with the Spanish influenza, I think they found some digged up some corpse up in the Arctic that someone had died up there, and they got DNA from there, and they were able to reverse engineer the virus from that, and they were able to just sequence the genome of this virus, and so they've been able to do research on this. They've had these severe deadly viruses doing all this research on it, ostensibly to develop vaccines, but it could also have been to develop some sort of nanotech to cause the same effect in the body. Cause the same effect if it's tiny, super tiny particle in the body. Viruses are super small, right? And they trigger this reaction. So we may have manufactured human-made viruses like that. Very possible, actually. So this answers why I was given this information that there's going to be a massive bird flu-like epidemic around the planet. And I was trying to figure out, how is that possible, really, with our vaccines and all this kind of stuff, Well, it's certainly possible if it's man-made, human-made, being done on purpose. That is possible. And then, of course, blamed on the comet. Yeah. Amazing stuff, huh? So, the thing that I've always focused on is leaving early, getting out of Dodge early. And now I'm seeing, wow, it certainly is justified. If this hypothesis turns into a theory and it really fits, then it is certainly justified to get out of here, because these things are going to happen. And scripture tells us these tribulation is going to happen, and it's going to be very, very terrible. And so also there are ETs who have such advanced technology that they can wreak havoc on planets. They most definitely can. And they may step in also at that time. When the comet passes, they may start zapping this world with electromagnetic pulses. They may stimulate the sun to do so. A lot of stuff is possible. They may be trailing the comet in a spaceship, so to speak, coming in with it, and using the comet again as a cover for what they're actually up to. All that stuff is highly, highly possible. So again, get out of harm's way. You're not like avoiding some natural process or something. That's nonsense. So I just felt this empowerment, like, hey, yeah, sidestepping is the right thing to do. Is absolutely the right thing to do to avoid this skullduggery. We don't have to subject ourselves to this nonsense. We're not learning anything at all. And ultimately, none of us is learning anything from existence whatsoever. But most people have trouble seeing that far, to that deeply. So a little less deep is to see an immediate situation. There's really nothing to learn about anything through all this tribulation whatsoever. Nothing. It's all fake. It's all a ruse, a scam, as it were. Blamed on the comet, blamed on the cosmos, blamed on God, God's judgment or something. No, it's all nonsense. So why subject yourself to this nonsense? It just doesn't add up. It's not something you want to do. So I expect this to keep developing very powerfully. And it's time, it'll be time soon to decide what to do. And we just have to trust that when we get the crystal clarity about the whole thing, we get it aligned and we understand what's going on, then we'll say, accept the remedy, say, of course, let's get out of here. Not gonna subject myself to that. That's absolutely nuts. And then that will somehow enable us to focus on how do we sidestep this whole situation, because we have the intent to do so. And the intent is tremendously powerful. When your intent is aligned, it's the most powerful force in the cosmos, for sure. Okay, so we are getting to that stage very, very soon. There's no doubt about it. All right, very great. That's it for this one.